In this tutorial, we will dive deeper into working with the Screens tab. Other than working with projection screens, you can also work with LED panels or displays. So, if you click on Displays, you will find a 40-inch generic display with a full HD resolution. You can just drag and drop it into the main window. On a basic level, you treat this screen the same as the projection screens you already know. If you click on it, you will find the settings in the inspector on the right-hand side. Almost right at the top, you see the canvas resolution, which is full HD, as I just mentioned. If, however, you want a different resolution, you can change it under panel resolution a bit further down. Let's now change it to 3840 by 2160. The canvas resolution will automatically adjust to the new values. The canvas resolution is the resolution with which the content will be used as part of compositing. Here you can find the position, size, and rotation. Way down below, we have an option called Choose Color, which allows you to allocate a color to the screen you're working with. Using this option makes a lot of sense to make it easier to organize and work with multiple screens. So if we just add another screen, we can then quickly change its color. The more screens you work with, the more likely it will be that you will want to organize them in an efficient way. Using Shift, you can lock the screens. You should already know the basic mechanisms from working with projection screens. We also have a nice new option which is called Show Labels. If you select it, your displays will show small labels that have their names on them. And yes, you can change their respective names as well. Let's just call our displays Display 2 and Display 1. If you go to the left of the interface, you will find your two displays under the Project tab. The great advantage of displays is that when you're switching to the Mapping tab, you will not need to add and allocate a projector. Instead, you can allocate an output directly to your display. On the right-hand side, you can find a selection mode as part of the Mapping tab. Especially with larger and more complex projects, it makes a lot of sense to use it to make sure you're selecting exactly what you want to select. You can choose between projectors and screens. A display gets treated like a screen. Once you select it, you can go to the Live tab and allocate it to a graphics card. You do this by right-clicking and selecting Assign Output to Selected Image Devices. If you now click on the display, you will see the output in the inspector on the right-hand side. Alternatively, you could also change the output here directly by using the available checkboxes.